A career in the Defence Force was a dream come true for Daniel Garforth.
It was so proud on the day he got in. As it was for me.
Daniel took his own life in 2014, just 2 years after joining the army. His mother, Nikki Jamieson, has since dedicated her life to fighting the scourge of veteran suicide. She spent years lobbying for this royal commission and, as its first witness, didn't hold back.
We send our young, fit and healthy sons and daughters to serve Australia. They are returned to us in a coffin. This needs to change.
Daniel was 19 when he enlisted, a cheeky young man with the world at his feet who wanted nothing more than a secure future for his daughter and to be someone she could look up to and be proud of. But posted away from home and isolated from his family, things quickly deteriorated.
Had I known, had I had a hint from defence that he was struggling in the way he was struggling, I would have been on the next flight up there and taken him home myself.
He was 21 when he died. His suicide note made plain his reasons.
The thing that has finally pushed me over the edge was this job. Constantly being demoralised and ridiculed, I just could not handle it anymore.
Daniel had tried to leave, but his discharge request was denied because he hadn't filled out his paperwork correctly.
If people want to leave, let them leave. What other employer in this country do you know? If you don't like that position you're in, you can't just walk out and say goodbye. You couldn't do that in defence.
Nikki lays the blame squarely at the feet of her son's superiors. She told the commission the warning signs were there, but ignored.
He reported to three different chain of commands, one of which recorded his conversation and secretly took that conversation to another chain of command. That is not on. We don't. Where did he have to go? He had nowhere to go, so he felt trapped.
Nikki's suffering was exacerbated in the aftermath of her son's suicide. Despite requests for Daniel's belongings, his laptop was never given to her. His phone was returned, but with the data wiped. She had to wait 4 years for the Inspector General's report into his death. And when it finally did arrive, Nikki says the tone was defensive and ignored the loyal and committed soldier Daniel was prior to his death. Her evidence kicked off 2 weeks of hearings in Brisbane before the commission heads to Wagga, Townsville, Canberra and Sydney.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. If they're not going to get it right now, well then when? How many more people have to die?
Samantha Butler for 10 News First.